Okay, boy oh boy, do we have a show for you.
Here at Stevenson School of the Arts, we are hosting our 5th annual Schoolwide Arts Day.
The lineup for today will be mask making. Yay!
You heard it, boys and girls. You are going to make a mask for your parents to wear to the gala, but shh, don't tell them.
So how are we going to make it?
I don't know. Miss Sonberg said something about paper mache.
I believe it is pronounced pop-e-a-mache.
No.
Agree to disagree.
Let's get to the video.
First, start by clearing your workplace. What is she doing? Painting her nails?
Cute color. Once your work area is cleared of all the unnecessary toys, you need to gather your materials. You will need gallon milk jug cut in half. Thank you, parents, especially Mrs. Hildebrandt.
Hey, isn't that considered a half a gallon?
A paintbrush, a cup of liquid starch, newspaper cut into strips. Thank you, Miss Karpowicz. Third through sixth, you will need a smallish square piece of cardboard and masking tape and tissue paper.
Tissue paper. That reminds me of a joke.
Oh boy.
How do you get a tissue to dance?
I don't know. How, Miss Vanderpool?
Put a little boogie in it.
Okay. After your workspace is cleared, you will need to construct a nose. Cut a square piece of cardboard. The larger the square is, the larger your nose. Cut halfway up and then fold the two flaps on top of each other.
That's a small nose.
Feel free to tape the flaps together so you can maneuver it.
Good idea. That would be terrible to tape your nose upside down. And remember to leave room at the bottom for the mouth.
After you figure out where you want it, use the masking tape to secure that nose down.
Masking tape? Get it?
Who wrote this stuff? Your nose down.
Want me to help? Let me see. Well, you know what? I think it looks great here, so let's get paper macheing. Is that even a word?
Sure it is. You will share some supplies, so we suggest you work with a partner. It's easier when you have help.
Yay.
Make sure your mask is facing the correct direction so that the jug part is towards your belly. Once we secure our nose for our 3rd through 6th graders.
Oops.
I'm so glad I have a partner.
I don't know if this partner is very helpful.
Nose secured. So make sure your mask is facing the correct direction. And we're going to start by dipping our brush in the liquid starch. Get a good amount on your brush.
But don't use your brush as a shovel.
And apply the starch. And pat down that newspaper.
All right. Is there anything good written on the paper? We're not missing anything important, are we?
Oh, Miss Vanderpool. This is old news.
Okay, I get it. Old news.
It looks like you'll be spreading the liquid on the jug itself and then placing that newsprint over the wet part of the jug. Make sure to lay the strips across the jug horizontally. This matters. Spread some more liquid over that strip and overlap onto the next strip. No need to place it directly over the first strip, just slightly over it will do.
I'm very proud of you. You're not using your brush as a shovel.
Thank you,
Miss Vanderpool. Very good.
Keep doing this all the way down, making sure to place them in the same directions. Don't worry, we'll switch directions later.
Man, she moves fast.
Once we get to the bottom, it gets a little tricky. It looks as though our model is trying to hold some of the pieces down for a little amount of time.
Wait, what? I have to touch the starch?
Sure! Okay, first layer should be on.
Yeah, right. I think we need to take a break to catch up. Aren't there supposed to be any commercials in this?
Let's watch a little more of Miss O'Connor's parade that she was showing. It looks like we're about to start our next layer.
Uh-oh. Another layer? How many layers are there?
I'm pretty sure that she said it was three, or maybe four. Look, we are switching directions. This time we're placing the strips up and down vertically. Start at one side and apply more liquid, adding strips as you go.
Very good. Don't forget to overlap slightly. Slightly.
Slightly. Be careful with the nose.
There she goes. Super speed again. Look at that.
Don't worry. We can pause it and rewind it. Third layer looks like it's the same as the first layer.
Man, I'm really getting into this watching you with this paper all over the place.
Finally, the last layer, the tissue paper. Ha! I get it now, a boogie in it.
Yes, it didn't take too long. Hopefully you've selected your tissue paper color by now. Don't forget to share. And why are we putting tissue paper on it?
So we don't have to paint it.
Oh, that makes sense.
Those clever ladies down in the art room. Look, she's measuring and cutting the paper. I bet she's going to give the other side to her partner. Here you go, partner.
Look, it's amazing.
So, spread a little more liquid starch over your entire mask. place the whole half sheet of tissue over it. Smooth it out and add more liquid. Feel free to use your fingertips to hold and press that paper in place.
Wow, look at this. My mask is super cool. Look how fast it happened, too.
At least I tried.
Yay, Mrs. Fleeger!